just echo what Shell said. We have the space. We have to stress that. We have the democratic space, even though, let's say, there is a tendency to restrict it. Added to that is precisely because there is that space and because of so many decades of fighting, we have a stronger civil society now. I recall during those times, it was mainly the students, the youth, and a few politicians like your dad. But now, we have a broader segment of society ready to fight. We have a very robust, very active civil society. And perhaps the last point is, again, because of our democratic gains, even the constitution we have right now really will put a constraint on any attempt to undermine democracy. One last point, just to answer a bit regarding education as a right. Some tend to be ideological about it. I'm more practical because free education, even for college, can be fine. If your model is social democratic, but you can aspire for that. One can aspire for that. But the question is, right now, we have to be practical. We don't have the resources, and if you do have the resources, as you said, it's a question of how you will allocate the resources. And in a situation, well, unlike Germany, for example, where more or less you have an equitable society, the resources needed now should really go to uplifting the poor. So yes, right to education, we want that, and college education in particular can be an a free universal college education can be an aspiration, even as we at this time emphasize that primary education or basic education should be universal.